Okay, so we're out here in Landers under the full desert sun, and today we're gonna be talking about the Dokio 300 watt foldable solar panel. These kind of foldable panels are really great and flexible if you want to be backed up in case there's a power outage or you just live off the grid or whatever your needs are. These foldable panels are super useful. So this is a kit, so it comes with a solar charge controller, and it's also got a variety of cords and even some clamps that you can use to hook up directly to your batteries, which is super cool. So I'm gonna be using one of these today for our generator. So my absolute favorite thing about this panel is that it's super portable, it's easy to carry, especially given that it's rated for up to 300 watts. So it's really awesome that this is a complete kit that comes with everything you need to start using it right away. You can use it without a generator, but if you do have a generator, you can get way more out of it too. So I think this set is a really good value for the price that you pay. I mean, I love that it comes with everything that you need to start using it right away. It's super easy to use, especially for how affordable it is. I think this kind of portable solar panel setup is really good for people who are new to solar and are just trying to figure out how it works. You don't really need any specialized equipment to use with it. It's literally just plug and play. So that's great for beginners. All right, so let's take a minute now to talk about the specs of this panel. So like I mentioned, it's a 300 watt foldable monocrystalline solar panel. It's got a nominal voltage of 18 volts. It comes with a 9.8 foot charging cable with various tips that you can use. All right, so here's the solar charge controller that the panel comes with. If you have like a different kind of battery system, maybe a DIY one or something like that, then you would connect this to the panel first before you connect it to your batteries. The solar charge controller will make sure that a safe amount of voltage and current is going into the battery so it doesn't overload the system. And a neat thing about this, if you look right here, it's got some built-in USB ports here. So even if you don't have a different kind of battery system, you can still plug in some phone cords or some other USB cables into this and connect it to the panel while it's in the sun. All right, so now I'm gonna show you a little more closely some of the accessories that it comes with. So these are the clamps that you would put onto the terminals of your solar battery. And it's got the different connector here as well. This panel comes with a bunch of different size tips that you can put on the adapter here. So you can use this with a variety of solar generators. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 6 different tips. So when you're using a solar panel like this, it's always important to make sure that it's facing towards the south. And depending on the time of year, you're gonna wanna have it oriented at different angles so that you'll maximize the solar input. And of course, you wanna have it be as unobstructed as possible from any barriers that would block the sun. Now, out here in the desert with absolutely blazing full sun, it's pretty easy to do. So we can definitely take advantage of solar power here.
First, we're gonna try the Dokio panel with our generator. Then we're gonna try it out with the solar charge controller that it comes with.
So today we're using this panel with one of our EcoFlow Delta generators, but I do believe you can use it with many other kinds of generators, including Jackery and other well-known ones. Just gotta make sure it's got the right tip for your device. So when you're using these kind of panels, obviously they gotta stay in the sun, while your generator should stay in the shade to protect it and so that it'll function better. So I'm gonna connect right here with one of the cables that came with. This is the end that's gonna go into the solar panel, and this is the XT60 end that's gonna go into my generator. All right, so we put in this end into the panel here, just like that.
And then just plug the other end into your generator.
All right, so now let's talk about how much juice this is bringing into our generator now. So we got it plugged in right here, and this thing is rated at 300 watts, but if you know anything about solar panels, they never bring in 100% of what their rated capacity is. So right now it's bringing in about 180 watts.
And it's hard to see it on the camera, but our battery is starting at about 40%.
So I'm pretty pleased with what it's bringing in right now. It's comparable to other foldable panels that I've used. If you're interested in using a panel like this, just make sure you get one that is gonna be safely rated to use with your own generator or batteries. Different generators have different specs, and they can only tolerate a certain amount of solar input, so definitely it's important to check it out. If you have a smaller generator, you might not be able to use a bigger panel like this. Just in the like 30 minutes or so that we've been out here, it's already gone up to on my battery 6 or 7%. All right, so we'll check on this later to see how it's doing. All right, so now I'm checking on the panel and the generator after we had lunch. It's been sitting here for a little more than an hour. Let's see. Before lunch, it was about 46 or 48%. Now it's up to 68% in just over an hour, which I think is really good. It looks like it's been pulling in about 170 to 180 watts over this time, but I'm really happy with the performance of it. So now I want to show you guys what it's like to use the solar charge controller with the solar panel to directly charge a phone or another USB device. All right, so right now I'm going to charge the cable here into the charge controller so I can charge my USB device right here. Then right away when you plug it in, you can check that it's working on the little screen here. It'll show the amperage and the voltage flowing through the device to make sure it's working properly. So you can cycle through a few of the different settings so you can check the different specs about what's happening with the device and the panel, all on the screen on the controller. And now I'm gonna plug in my USB light right here And there we go. So right now the power is flowing from the solar panel through the cable, through the charge controller, and then into my USB light right here. And I think this is a really great feature that you can charge USB devices without getting an expensive battery or generator or anything like that. It really increases the utility and versatility of this foldable solar panel. This is great for people who wanna get started with solar, but they don't want to invest a lot of money or they feel overwhelmed. This type of portable panel is really great for the flexibility and utility it offers for many different kinds of activities and lifestyle, like RV life, van life, camping. Even if you live in a small off-grid place like we do and you have a little system, these are definitely handy. You can easily carry this around your property and use your generator in different spots. You know, compared to the rigid panels, this is much easier to carry. These would even be useful in case of a disaster. You can quickly just pop this out and make sure you've always got your power when you need it. And I really love that you can use the panel and the solar charge controller to charge USB devices, even if you don't have a generator or a separate battery. That's only gonna work though while it's bringing in power from the sun. So the Dokio panel is really simple to use. It's lightweight considering the size of the panel. It's got a built-in handle. It's got a handy pocket in it so you can store the cables and everything. It comes with a bunch of different tips for the cables so you can use it with a wide variety of different solar generators, including ours, which is EcoFlow. So the absolute best thing about this Dokio 300 watt foldable solar panel is it's a kit. So it literally comes with everything that you need to get started with your own quick and easy solar power system. You don't need to get expensive batteries or an expensive generator. As long as you have something with USB, you can plug it right in. It's also a huge bonus that if you do have a generator or a battery system, it's also really easy to just plug and play and then you're good to go. And I'm pleased with the power that it was bringing in. It's charging my generator up really quick. I'm gonna get a lot of use out of this over the years to come. So the panel's been sitting up by itself now for over an hour. It's standing up to any wind gusts that we have out here, which is a really huge positive that I can trust it to stand up on its own without tipping or blowing over, because obviously if it falls over, it's not gonna work. Really recommend this panel for people who are just getting into solar or people who just want a simple backup solar power system for their flashlights or other emergency devices. I think anyone could figure out how to use it and get going. So if you guys are interested in trying out this panel for yourselves, we're gonna put a link in the description and you can go ahead and check that out. And if you guys enjoy this video, please give us a like. Also, if you guys have any questions or comments, please let us know in the comments and we'd be happy to answer them to the best of our ability. And you guys, please don't forget to subscribe so you can see more of our off-grid life out here in the desert. We're right now in the middle of remodeling our little cabin out here, which is super exciting. And we've got a lot to share and show from that. So make sure you don't forget to hit that bell so you get notifications if we drop something new. Until next time, stay wild, friends.